17th of May 2018.
This is a beautiful, what breed is this?
Cairn Terrier.
Cairn Terrier, very rare in Singapore. How old is it now?
About 6 years old.
6 years old and male neutered, right?
Yeah.
Never go out of the house, so it didn't get ticks for so many years, right?
Mm.
Ever go to groomers?
Groomers have.
And so lucky he went to groomer, but didn't get ticks. Because groomers there and vets also, there are places where a lot of dogs are around, you see. So these dogs were so lucky until recently, the owner discovered those fat ones which are no more here now. And those are the mother ticks. The mother ticks, they are engorged with blood. And how this dog got it, we don't know, because the last month, did he go anywhere?
I was in the house.
So he didn't go out of the house, he didn't go to groomers?
No, the last grooming was probably not even this year.
Okay, so how he got it, most likely from the neighbor's dog or the stray dogs outside. But this dog must have gone outside the house, right?
Before? Have
no, the last 1 or 2 months. Outside means outside the gate.
Outside.
Some dogs, they don't go outside the gate, but some dogs do.
See? Near the gate, near the garden there.
So the ticks come in. So now there are two ways, as far as the dog is concerned for tick, treatment of tick infestation. One way is, of course, soak the dog into a tick wash and then rub onto it and then leave it there and the ticks will die. That is an insect tick wash. Only thing is better to wear e-collar so that the dog doesn't lick his body and then gets poisoned. That is the disadvantage of the tick wash. The other way, of course, there are oral tablets, which are monthly or 3 monthly. This is the oral one, or the front line, which they use to put on the
spot application
on the neck area, and the front line is put here there. See, once a month, and it's been used for many years already. So some owners find
resistance.
It's not effective. So now. Come, turn over and see any more ticks. Ready? Okay. Now, this Cairn Terrier is one of those beautiful ones which I seldom see in Singapore because it's not popular. It's very rare. Okay, now you can see here. Now, this dog definitely has been licking his lower part for some reason.
Licking around here and there also sometimes. Yeah. We thought it was just itchy or something.
It's not normal to have these pigmented areas. So why is he licking? This one, the armpit. So he has been having an infection on the lower body.
All these black spots, are they normal?
Licking. Some are due to licking until it becomes black. The skin becomes black. So this one is the elbow also. Okay, but the... So this one should not be there in the first place, this the hyperpigmentation. So I think your floor must have chemicals. Where he lies down, your floor must be quite irritating. Yes. Where he sleeps? On the car porch?
In a cage.
So it must be wet or something. So this should not be there. Yes. for the... Now the only advantage, the only good thing about this is it doesn't lick his paws, right?
Not recently.
Now as I talk, this dog has very bad breath. Very bad breath now. You can see the gum disease. You see the whole gum is already dark red. It should be pink color. And I wouldn't be surprised if there are some gum tumors. Now you can see this premolar 4, this tooth is really black and the roots are exposed. So it's a periodontal disease, stage 4. Stage 4, and I'm surprised no teeth came out. They must have lost some teeth, right?
But they want me to.
Okay, turn this side, and I see this side. So, 6 years old. Okay. Now you see this one, this is really bad. This is the carnassial tooth of premolar 4. And he lost some teeth behind because there's no more teeth behind.
Mm.
Normally, they are the molar 1 and 2. There's no more already. So he did lose his teeth, but it wasn't obvious. This one is a bit loose already. This one, you see the
the root is exposed, this is the incise. And then the middle one is lost, the front one there, the front teeth. Lower front teeth is gone also there. There should be six, but there's only one. And on top, the front teeth is loose there, you see there? Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So one has dropped off. So in other words, this dental is quite important. And the dog is lethargic. Lethargy is due to, most likely to the infection from the tick bites. Tick bites, they may have bacteria and of course the parasites, the tick fever. But there's no fever today. It doesn't mean there won't be any fever tomorrow. So we will do the test for tick fever. And sometimes the tick fever parasites cannot be seen immediately because they need time to multiply and to appear in the red blood cells, baby seal and the others. So
aerosolysis.
So in my practice, normally I will give them anti-tick injection as a prevention rather than wait till you get it. Although some vets will wait until they really get it, then they give. But of course, preventive is better. So other than that, so the owner has to decide whether he wants to have a tick wash, and then he applies his front line onto the skin here, or normally I would advise shift on board so it becomes hairless. And then at home, because the garden is full of ticks, the house and the rooms are full of small ticks, so the owner can see on the skin, they can pick
more
up.
Visible.
And on the paws in between, so they can see. So that's the advantage of it. And other than that, so we will do that today. So you want to have it quick, Bob?
As in shave. In your pepper.
Okay. Then we will recommend the oral one because oral is more effective.
Okay.
It's a new drug. It's a new one compared to frontline. Then once a month. There are two options, once a month or once in 3 months. So I recommend the once a month because once in 3 months it might be a bit strong.
Potent,
Some dogs may not be able to take it, but once a month is okay. So now we'll do a blood test and do a test for ticks. Baby seal, Ehrlichia, and anaplasma. And then after that, the IV drip with antibiotics. And it goes home tomorrow. And then the dental will be done next week when he's much better. In the meantime, the owner is supposed to cut the grass short, clear the vacuum, the floor, and spray some
tick spray
onto the cracks and
crevices,
where the dog, but actually the dog goes around the whole house, right? So there's no one area.
Still safe area.
And then the car porch also, presume. Anyway, with the dog being bought, you see everything. Sometimes the big ones are still there. The big fat ones drop onto the floor. We don't know whether it's still around. And then they lay eggs. Okay, finish it. So